Hello everyone, Lothartine Skale here, also known as Skale, and welcome to Venba. I had been hearing about this game for a while, especially since it was on another one of the Switch showcases. But from what I understand, it's the story of an immigrant family and food. And it teaches you how to make some of these dishes. And as a person who loves food with a whole bunch of flavor, I am in. So let's... Oh, we have a recipe section! Okay, so I don't have any of these unlocked, but I'm really curious how that plays into effect. Hold on, I should really... This is beautiful to look at, but my god, it's killing my brain cells. Yep, those are that. What's the radio? Oh, I can... Nope, we're just gonna keep it on default. Okay, so let's play. Ooh. The hand movements are really awesome aesthetically, but they keep messing with my brain on every sense. I can't read that. Think well before you dare and ruminate once in action. 1988. I don't hear anything. Oh, that's an airplane blanket. God, do I know that feeling well. My grandmother used to steal a whole bunch of those from airlines. And leaving already? Oh, I didn't realize I was gonna have to do talking. Where's my mouse? Oh, it doesn't exist. Yeah, that's how I would assume that said. Sorry, did I wake you? What time is it? 8. How are you feeling? Nauseous? Why is that an option? Tired. Just like yesterday. Oh, she preggers. That's why. Ah. Okay, I'll call your school and say you can't come in today. Thanks. Is she preggers? Where's all my background audio go? Like, what happened to the music? Does it only come in for, like, the actual gameplay portion? Because this feels pretty gameplay-y. I was just about to leave for work. You should go back to sleep. What about your lunch? There's some leftover... Idili? Like, I eat a lot of Indian food, and I have no idea how to pronounce any of it. So, idli batter and garlic chutney from yesterday. I know what chutney is. Thank you. You can steam some of those... I feel like I'm just saying this wrong. Idlis? Idlis, quickly. I don't know if I can figure that out. What the hell you mean? You a grown man. You can figure that out. It's okay. I was just about to leave. No. We get you real food. Then again, this is like explaining how food works in some cases to my fiance. He can cook and he can cook well, but he prefers my cooking over his, so leave that where it lays. It's just idlis, very easy. It'll take me too long. Venba, don't worry about it. Isn't my name Io? Or did he just say Io, like as in the good Midwestern ope? I can survive on the coffee machine. Fuck, though. I really need to, like, make my swearing more practical for the stuff that I'm recording. No. Like, don't get me wrong. I do that at work, where I rely solely to get through the day on a bottle of soda pop. I'm not going to tell the brand until I get sponsored by them. I would love to be sponsored by them. But that's not happening. But I get through the entire day on a bottle of soda, and if any of my coworkers are like, hey, I don't feel like finishing these fries, like the flavor just don't hit on them, like they oversalted them, I'm that human garbage disposal, but vegetarian, so I own that proudly. Look, I will just get up. Fine, I'll make it then. Just wait 5 minutes. Then, but really, it's fine. Nope. I'm getting up. No, 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 no. I need to make lunch for myself anyway. Just tell the school I'll be done in a minute. Am I a teacher? Or a st who? What am I? Who am I? Okay. Do you mean you don't know if you can figure that out? I mean, I get it. It's the 80s. This is a different time. But you are a grown man. I think you need to like learn to cook. That's a general cooking thing. Oh, you poor thing, you're exhausted. Okay, let's get this done fast. Although, Tattered Family Cookbook. Oh, man. Oh, every family has one of these at least once. My mother's is at her place. I have none of the family recipes, though. I don't even have her coleslaw recipe, and that's like what she's kind of famous for. You know, every parent has their. Tell me in the comments, what is the one dish that, like, one of your parents is famous for, like in their local cycles? There's got to be one, right? Like maybe somebody's mom makes like a really good. Oh my God, why? All that's coming into my head is the word chutney, and that's not right. Like maybe somebody's mom makes like a really good mac and cheese. Another one makes a really good like, just a really good bowl of green beans. You know, like they got some good flavor in those. My mother's is her coleslaw. That's like her thing. Mine at this point is a pierogi dish. Where I get the frozen cheddar pierogies. I know, look, it's already blasphemous enough, but I'm broke and I don't have a lot of time and I don't know how to make pierogies from scratch. But anyway, you get the cheese pierogies, you cook them up however you were going to cook them up, and then you just sprinkle honey and cinnamon on them, which is a really simple dish, but it's really popular at parties. Another one that was really popular at the last party I went to is taking fresh pineapple, not canned, it does have to be fresh. Slice that up and then coat the pineapple in tajin spice, which you usually find in the Mexican aisle for those of you who have no clue what I'm talking about, and it's delicious. Anyway, yeah, let's try your mother's recipe for once instead of just doing it however you were gonna do it. However, I will tell you my mac and cheese is better than my mother's. Not that I'm trying to call out my mother. My mother makes delicious food. She really does. But we get like a frozen mac and cheese that she'll heat up and she'll like be like, oh yeah, I added all these cheeses to it and like that makes it upgraded. And me, I'm like, no. See, when I do it, I definitely grate some fresh Parmesan over this like stovetop mac and cheese. It's not Kraft, by the way. This is like, and it's not Velveeta. Like we have actual like real like there's. It's kind of like a Stouffer's thing, but it's not, but it is. But anyway, we grade over that, and then what I do is I saute up some broccoli in some olive oil, salt, and pepper, and then I add fresh like butter to it after it's mostly done cooking, so this way it bakes in that butter flavor, but I don't burn the butter. And then I pour that into the mac and cheese with some fresh salt, some fresh grated pepper and then some garlic powder, and I mix that together. And oh my God, I had it for dinner last night. I overdid the garlic powder last night. Big whoops, but it was so good. I highly recommend that. If you want something that's going to spice up your anything, grilling up some broccoli like that just makes a huge difference. And I don't mean put it in the microwave. The reason people think that they don't like broccoli is because, especially heated, is because it becomes mushy after the microwave. No, I'm sauteing it on a stove so it gets hard and crispy and kind of crunchy, but it's got flavor. Like not you're not getting it to the crispy stage, but it's not mush. It's so good. I promise you. Try that. Change that. At the bare minimum, just throw in some buttered noodles you were making anyway and see how that changes the flavor. But anyway, the way I make idlis are never as soft as hers. And they would always cheer me up when I'm feeling sick. I should make them for her today. If the recipe is still readable, that is. Oh, there we go. I was like, where's my music? Okay, so we have music for the cooking segments. That makes sense. Oh, there's a lot of things happening. Okay, so step one, we open the book. I'm turning this down in my ears. What is this? Oh, I don't have one of these. Idli plate. I don't have one of those in life. Towel. Okay. Cooker. Valid. Holes let the steam through. Oh, so it's kind of like the bao bun stacks. I got you. Okay, so water and batter. What is the batter made out of? These also have holes so batter can cook. Make sure to do something to it or it will leak. Arrange the plates so steam can cook batter properly. I know that these are your mother's recipes, but once you've figured them out, please write them in a new cookbook so that this way they preserve better for time. I have not made idli with these kinds of plates before. Well, that's probably why they're not as soft. The only difference from mine seems to be that the holes in the plates, so steam is super important. The recipe also calls for towels. I'm not sure why. Maybe you put towels over each layer? But Amma. See, I can get everything else right. But Amma swears this method makes the idlis a lot softer. So. Okay, so. I assume I put the water in there. No point putting in a plate with it. Oh my god, okay. Well, I don't even have it on, but. Okay. I don't think towel sh I should cover the batter with a towel. I think you should, but. We'll do something with it or else it'll leak. Does that just mean at the very top? Let me learn about idlis. How it's made. Idlis are a breakfast staple. Well, if I ever get this kind of apparatus in my home, that's what I'll be making, I guess. Are they supposed to be like little pancakes? They ask so little of you, but they give back so much. Simply grind rice and some fermented lentils for that cloudy batter. Really? That's it? And then what? Add water or olive oil? Because I have lentils and rice in my cabinet right now. And steam it to make those soft, fluffy cakes. Anyone can make it, it's so easy. Except for my husband, I guess. Valid. Though I never made it with my mother's cooker, so this might be a challenge. Tell me the other thing about them. How it's served. Idlis are versatile, and it's all about what you eat it with. Oh! Chili powder and some sesame oil. Oh, God, that sounds good. I have sesame oil. I don't know if I have chili powder. I think I do, actually. That'd be great. Of course, the staples like sambar, which I don't have, and coconut chutney. Oh, coconut chutney are great too. I'm just starving. I ate before this, but I love Indian food like so much. There's an Indian place about 10 minutes away from me, down in a valley, and I love that place. You can get different spice levels on your food, and like I always max it out for me, and my fiance can't handle any of it. But oh my just a really good spicy paneer taka masala with like a side of some rice. Oh, I'm gonna try not to drool. But eating it with some leftover chicken gravy is my favorite. There are a lot of options. Okay, so No point putting a plate. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, no, no. How do I take that out? How do I undo? Oh, resume. Go back. Oh, I can full on reset. Okay. Right, there's no point in doing that. I still don't understand what I'm doing wrong with this towel thing. Okay. Some of this I've got figured out, though. Okay. I still really think that I should, you know. But then what do I cover it with? That's not right. I know something's up here. No? Something's up with these, and I can figure out the rest of that. I just don't understand. This is hard. Really could use a hint. Put a towel on each idly plate before putting the batter on it. What? I thought the entire point of we didn't want it on top of it was we didn't want to get this on the towel. I also think the alignment of the plate matters, and I should make sure that each plate's... Okay, that part I got. I just... What the hell? Alright. No, oh, hold on. I need water in there first, because otherwise it's not going to steam. So interesting. Okay, I never would have thought to put the plate... Like, the towel on the thing. Oh, because that would make sense, because then it wouldn't run through the bottom, in theory. There we go. Now, how high do I cook it? I should close the lid before turning the stove on. Where's the... Oh, this is the lid. Oh, well, that makes sense. All right, let's see how it turns out. Yeah, they really had to help me out with that beginning because I never would have figured that out about the towel. That should be long enough. Let's remove the lid and see how it turned out. Ah, it's done. God, I would love one of these. Okay. Well, do you feel better now that you're looking at it? Oh, look. I successfully make idlis. Oh, wow. You even took the time to make our faces. Aww. That's so cute. I think you forgot about my beard, though. Look. You really didn't have to do this. It's fine. What else could I do? My husband can't figure out idlis. Why does this feel... Don't get me wrong. Like, I couldn't figure him out. But this also isn't a food that's prominent in my culture. Like, I can figure out mac and cheese if I am left alone to my own devices with nothing but a block of cheddar, some heavy whipping cream, and the mac and the cheese. Like, I can figure that out a little. But something about this just strikes me as very, Oh, God. Not malicious compliance. What's the thing? Like, feigned incompetence. Or there's a word for it. And I can't remember what it is. But, like, where men pretend not to know how to do things so that... Or do them purposely badly so that women won't ask them to do them again. And I know that's, like, not necessarily a gender role, only thing. Like, only men do it and only women get the butt end of it. But I mean, like, specifically, it's just more common in those kind of relationship dynamics. Because you'll see it all over TikTok. But yeah, feigned incompetence sucks. Don't do it. It's manipulative and horrible. Don't do it. This would be a different story, by the way, if the entire time I was working in the kitchen on these idlis, if he was standing next to me watching, being like, I can't figure it out. I know you're not feeling good. Let me learn from you this time so that the next time that you're sick, I can just step up to the plate. Venba, I told you to go to sleep. So what, that you could starve? The way that you're talking about it was really not cool, man. You've been feeling sick and exhausted, and I'm probably pregnant. You didn't have to cook. It's not a big deal if I skipped lunch once. No, that's a very big deal. You really do need your energy to get through the day. I skip lunch, not because it's a healthy thing, but twofold. One, I'm broke, like, all the time. Not, like, trying to get, like, a pity me party going, but, like, I'm broke. And number two, I'm still in the process where I'm gaining a significant amount of weight, and I'm not burning a lot of calories throughout the day, even though I eat, like, a small breakfast and then a large dinner. So, with that in mind, like, I can go longer without necessarily needing the food. I think of it more like a fast than necessarily, like, going without a meal. Pavlin. Yeah. It's hard for me to figure out the two A's thing. You're making me choose between resting and letting you starve. Yeah, that's not healthy, man. That's not a fair choice to me. You're not letting me starve. I know, but that's what it feels like. That is what it feels like, and it's pretty manipulative, and you got to realize that you put her in kind of a shitty situation, man. And even if I had let you leave, I couldn't sleep peacefully. Yeah, thank you. Don't sit there and be like, well, then what would I eat? Like, no. No. Don't bring this back on to you for, like, you know, well, I need service too. No. This is, I wouldn't feel right about it. I know I shouldn't, but you know I would. Is it so hard for you to cook even on days like this? No. You're right. Sorry. We have progress. I full on support this man. Did you look for tickets back home? Yes. It's expensive, but we can manage it. So, do you think we should go? I don't know. Let me ask my boss again if he can make me full-time. Oh, no. We're doing this in part-time in 1988. Oh, fuck. Unless the school gives you more shifts, or my boss changes his mind, it's going to be tough to stay in Canada. Yeah. I had a feeling of that. You know, there are other options, but what is it, that he doesn't want to change workplaces, or is it that he's reliant on his visa? I wouldn't mind going back. I'm sure I can teach again at my old job. And there's nothing really keeping us here. It would be nice. You say that, but I guarantee you you're pregnant. Okay, well, why don't you leave with me now? I'll walk you to the doctor's office before I go to work, and then we're going to find out that you're pregnant. Oh no, I'm sure all I need is some sleep. Now go to the doctor, sweetie, please. You've been saying that for 2 days now. Come on, I'll walk you. Doctors are free here. God damn. And I think that's where we're going to leave off this episode. I like this. I feel very weird that there's a lack of music going on in the background during most of this. But I feel like I'm learning to cook something. Though I am curious to learn more about these idlis. So anyway, that's all the time that we've got for this episode. Take care, everybody.